Feel free to check out my TeePublic after the video, and support me on Patreon. Watch till the end of the video for more. In a previous video, I talked about the first Garo series from legendary tokusatsu filmmaker Keita Amemiya. This time, I'd like to touch on something from the early years of his career in directing tokusatsu, and that would be the film that really helped Amemiya come into his own, Zoram. Consisting of two movies and an OVA series, Zoram is considered a classic when it comes to the underground new wave era of tokusatsu from the 80s and 90s, where, thanks to advancements in filmmaking technology, filmmakers were able to make tokusatsu films of their own, like Mamoru Oshii's The Red Spectacles and Shinya Tsukamoto's Tetsuo the Iron Man. Before Zoram, Amemiya worked on shows like Spielbon, as well as Jibon, which he created. It was around this time he'd go on to direct Mirai Ninja, which heavily established a lot of stylistic motifs that would get carried over in almost all of his work since, Zoram being one of them, which would mark his first theatrical feature film. In fact, Zoram was actually meant to be a sequel to Mirai Ninja, but because he couldn't get the budget, he had to stick with something else. Plot goes is that a bounty hunter named Iria and her AI system Bob, yes, the AI is named Bob, are hunting down the alien Zoram, who travels planet to planet to not only feast but replicate itself, using whatever organisms are living there. That's such a terrifying concept. An alien who not only eats you but uses your DNA to clone itself? As you would imagine, Zoram winds up on Earth as Iria and Bob set up a gate to an alternate dimension to apprehend the alien. Two electricians named Tepe and Kamiya accidentally get transported with Iria. So now Iria not only has to take care of Zoram, she has to protect these guys from getting killed. First thing I just want to get out of the way is the atmosphere. Amemiya does a fantastic job using shadows and lighting in unique ways to convey fear and terror, especially in this desolate dimension that most of the film is set in. In a way, it also helps makes it unsettling with how vast it is, as our characters are truly isolated in this space with such a terrifying creature. And the cinematography by Hiroshi Kirokoro makes it all the more imposing, as every shot of Zoram oozes with both majesty and dread. Speaking of which, Zoram is easily one of the most unique creatures in tokusatsu. On top of the aforementioned concept, her design comes off as a sort of nightmarish, otherworldly traveler, especially with that poncho and quote-unquote sombrero, which is actually her head. Also, that smile gives me shivers every time, and my god, that chanting. I also love how the movie manages to combine suitmation, puppetry, and stop motion, a trend in Amemiya's work during this period, with Zoram's different forms, which really makes you curious about the biology of such a creature. By the way, that's Mizuho Yoshida in the Zoram suit, same actor who played Godzilla in GMK. And I gotta talk about the characters. The electricians Tepe and Kamiya have a lot of funny banter with one another, and even in life-threatening situations, they somehow manage to make a scene both hilarious and terrifying at the same time. Even when Zoram bites a huge chunk out of one of their arms. Huge props to Kunihiro Ida and Yukijiro Hotaru, who played Gonza and Garo, for their talent here. They have wonderful chemistry. But the real star of the movie, aside from the movie's namesake, Yuko Moriyama as Iria. She's a tough, charismatic, no-nonsense badass, but is also aware of her limits, and has a heart. And wow, she kicks major ass. I also love the bond that she forms with Kamiya and Tepe, as it definitely shows a more human side of her. And there's Bob. Bob is really cool. I like how instead of being the typical cliche AI assistant, he's literally some dude's consciousness that's just uploaded into a computer, which really gives him a lot of personality. Overall, Zoram is a classic, definitely one of Amemiya's best. But the fun doesn't stop there, because Zoram has a sequel. In Zoram 2, Iria and Bob are out to retrieve an ancient artifact called the Camelite. However, Zoram appears once more and— wait, Zoram is good now? Nope, she's still seeking to take over the Earth, this time with a new cyber-enhanced body. Speaking of which, I really like how Zoram resembles Anubis in this film. The film also sees the return of Kamiya and Tepe, and seeing them and Iria reunite is probably one of the most wholesome moments in tokusatsu. It's almost like a family reunion, except a lot less awkward. You truly feel like that these three are very good friends, especially since the movie really comes off as a natural continuation of Zoram 1. Unfortunately, this one doesn't have the same surreal and atmospheric layer as its predecessor, but Zaddam 2 definitely makes up for it with its set pieces and action scenes. Plus, the music is pretty banging as well. And though it may come off as a bit of a retread of the first movie, Zaddam 2 is still such a solid experience. And now we get to Iria, Zaram the Animation, a 6-episode prequel OVA from Ashi Productions and directed by Tetsuro Amino. Here we see what types of adventures that Iria had endured before coming across the alien Zaram. In fact, this is where we learn where Zaram comes from and what her motives are. And we even see Bob before he was turned into a computer. While I do wish Yuko Moriyama and Masakazu Honda reprise their roles as their respective characters, Aya Hisakawa and Masaru Ikeda still do a really good job bringing these characters to life. We even learn more about Iria's backstory, as she had a brother that would unfortunately be killed and assimilated by Zaddam, setting up her hatred for the beast we see in the films. Also, Shigeru Chiba is in this anime, so you know it's really good. While I wouldn't call Iria Zaram the Animation a must-watch, it does make for some excellent supplementary material for the films. As of now, Zaram is only on DVD from Media Blasters, but is unfortunately out of print and goes for stupid prices on eBay. But Zaram 2 has a Blu-ray release, also from Media Blasters. I'm sorry, what? And as for Iria Zaram the Animation, it's available for free with ads on Retro Crush. Honestly, Zaddam is one of the best sci-fi series I've had the pleasure of experiencing. So definitely check it out, and if you like what you see, then definitely consider supporting me on Patreon, where for a single dollar, your name can appear at the end of every future upload. Other than that, you can also get early access to videos, exclusive content, commission video requests, and receive a t-shirt of your choice from IT Public. Also want to give huge shoutouts to Zachary Nelson, Yerm, and SIH for becoming new patrons. Greatly appreciate the support, y'all. And once I reach enough patrons, I'll do a video covering several unmade Godzilla films, so if that's something you'd like to see, then go support me on Patreon. And if you want to hear me stutter for 2 hours, we did an episode about the works of Keita Amamiya on Toku Titancast a while back, so feel free to check that out. And feel free to like, share, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, and this is Titan Goji, signing off.